on land or on land.
Located on a peninsula of Sandusky, Ohio, it spans 364 acres and overlooks scenic Lake Erie. Its thrill-filled rides shoot you up, drop you down, get you soaking wet, let you face your worst fears, spin you round and round, and twist you every which way around. Cedar Point has been recognized by Guinness Records as the park with the largest number of rides, 68. And the greatest number of roller coasters, 14. With more than 3.5 million people flocking to its gates every summer, it's just like a city. And it has its own traffic control and police station. It operates 15 sit-down restaurants, 146 food outlets, 4 hotels, a marina, campgrounds, water park, miniature golf course, its own laundry service, lodging for 4,000 of its 5,000 seasonal employees, and its own printing shop. It has sand and surf, shows, singing, dancing, and thrills for the little ones. So what does it take to operate the world's largest amusement park? You'll take a ride on the wild side and go behind the scenes to discover what your average day is like at the world's largest amusement park. Cedar Point's 14 coasters have given more than 360 million rides. Their arsenal includes the Mean Streak, Cedar Point's tallest, fastest, and largest wooden coaster. First thing in the morning, coaster maintenance begins. It requires inspectors to check every inch of the coaster's track to keep it safe.
Every day I walk the track to do a visual inspection of the track itself, any of the bracing, any of the structure, make sure everything's intact. Sometimes these track bolts, they'll develop a little crack at the bottom. If we see a piece of cracked track, we change it out right away.
Inspecting Mean Streak will consume 2 to 3 hours.
Got my fall protection in place, tied off to the ride. They don't want to let me fall a maximum of 6 feet.
The safety crew is required to do their inspection even in the rain, unless there's lightning.
Right now I'm checking the gauge at each one of these gauge brackets that are alongside the bed wood here. We can adjust the gauges accordingly, bring the gauge in or out. One of the things I really like is when you come to work that early, 6 o'clock in the morning when we start, the park seems to be asleep. And just to see the people start coming around the park, coming into work, and the sun's coming up, and it's like the park's waking up from its sleep. That's really neat.
Around the same time, a different type of inspection is required from Millennium Force, the park's tallest and fastest steel coaster.
The steel coasters differ from the wooden coasters. Because of the weather, it affects the steel. The heat and cold make it expand and contract. And you just need to look at all the joints good and all the fasteners and just make sure that everything is tight and where it should be. This is the main drive system for our Millennium roller coaster. It's very unique because it's the only cable drive system in the world. It operates very smoothly and very quickly. We inspect the cable to make sure that it doesn't have any flat spots or worn spots on it, to make sure that it's in good shape.
Rick uses a special maintenance cart to ascend the ride's 310-foot lift hill, where he inspects lift parts in the highest section of the track.
I love coming up here in the morning, and it's the best view in the park, actually. You get to see every ride in the park.
After maintenance has finished its inspection, ride operators begin the morning test runs.
Right now we're going up the lift. It's about 310 feet. everything is running right. Of course, every morning, there are a lot of bugs. That is a typical test run for the Malayan Force, and it passed the test. Bugs everywhere.
You want to see the point or something?
See the point.
Are you guys going to see the point or one of the resorts?
We want to go to Soap City.
Soap City? Okay. Yeah.
Thousands of guests arriving in the morning could easily create a massive gridlock if they weren't managed efficiently.
One of the biggest challenges is just sorting the traffic out because there's so many different places they could be going. And we use a couple of techniques to help sort it out through the parking lot. We put direction notes on windows of cars that are going to the hotels and the Camper Village and Soak City Water Park. So the traffic directors can sort that out visually before they even approach their intersections.
Stay down back.
Stay straight on this road, then it followed all the way around the park, okay? Thank you.
With the volume of traffic that we have coming into Cedar Point, it's necessary for us to direct it to particular parking areas. If we just let them go wherever they want to, it'd be chaos. This is where all the traffic coming into Cedar Point is split into the various lots that we're parking. Physically, it is very demanding. The first week a traffic controller is working, their arms feel like they're going to fall off until they get conditioned to it, because there's a lot of upper body motion. The parking lot is approximately 64 and a half acres. Our capacity is just a little over 10,000 cars, and that's in the main parking lot. We have overflow parking that we can handle another 2,000 to 3,000 cars. On a Saturday, we will pull everything up to capacity. This is just a small part of the whole operation, but the most rewarding part about working here is the happy faces you see on the children when they're coming in. I think that's what it's all about.
Just before the front gates open, the general manager wraps up his inspection. A 30-year employee of Cedar Point, Don Myers, can spot anything that's amiss.
We got two pieces of plywood covering up a hole, and there's a black pipe coming out of it. Can we get this thing covered up?
We introduce about 3.5 million people a year. Up at the front gate right now, there's close to 1,500, 2,000 people that are waiting to get in. And as soon as the gates open, what the employees refer to as running of the bulls will take place.
Meanwhile, park president and CEO Dick Kinzel begins his Saturday walk through the park.
So it enables me to see how the park is progressing and the cleanliness and the service and things like that to make sure it's up to Cedar Point standards. Do your kids get on it? Thanks for coming. The other reason that I'm really out here is things that our managers are so engrossed in the day-to-day operations of the business is things that they maybe don't see because they're so engrossed in making sure that people get in the park is music, sounds, and atmosphere, the things that the customer sees.
Park guests staying at any of Cedar Point's four hotels often fill up for breakfast before hitting the rides.
My job as a server is to make sure that guests get their food in a timely fashion as much as I possibly can. Really, it depends on the cook. Order in.
Thank you.
The hardest part, I would say, would be when there's a rush of people and there are five tables who all got sat at one time, but then they all want to see you, trying to make sure that they're all happy.
That's for you. Thank you. You too. And that's for you.
Have a good afternoon.
Thank you.
Two coffees. Another hot chocolate?
Of course. I'm doing pretty good. I haven't broken anything.
I'm a bitch. No.
Oh my God.
I did not.
You bring it up all the time.
He's lying.
Courtney is one of 350 servers who works at the park's 15 sit-down restaurants.
Now see, that wasn't me that did that.
Cedar Point's 4,000 seasonal employees live in dormitories that are located on and off-site. During their off time, they can enjoy one of the best perks of their job.
I like being here at Cedar Point because although it's a work setting, you get the opportunity to come out and play and ride rides. I mean, it's one of the greatest amusement parks in the country, so you get to take advantage of that.
There comes the Gemini.
Think I'll go catch a ride.
The Gemini is a dual racing coaster with a wooden structure and a tubular steel track.
The Gemini coaster was built in 1978, and at the time that this was built, it was the highest coaster in the world at 125 feet. And it's always proven to be one of the most successful coasters that we've ever put in at Cedar Point.
While Cedar Point is known for its extreme rides, including its 300-foot-tall Power Tower, which blasts passengers up its structure and thrusts them down at speeds of 55 miles per hour, its most popular ride, however, is one of the mildest.
All our engines were originally used at some place in the United States besides here. Most of them for the early 1920s. They were steel mill engines. Two of them were steel mill engines. Two of them were plantations engines from Louisiana. The running gear is all original. Newer boilers, they've been updated to make sure everything stays in specs and safe. We need to have as safe of operations as we possibly can. We do everything to ensure that here. We start a wood fire in the engine to get pressure up a little bit, and then once the wood fire is burning good, we'll throw the coal to it. It boils our water, basically, which makes the steam, which powers the engine. That's what makes the engine go.
Prepping the railroad takes six engineers working 2 hours each morning.
Normally, we're one of the highest capacity rides in the park. We'll haul anywhere from 2 to 2.5 million people annually. People still seem to enjoy it. It is a nice, relaxing ride. It's a step back in time. One person can't operate a railroad. It takes a team. That's what makes a railroad run.
We mend and repair all the uniforms. We replace zippers. We also do buttons and hemming.
The morning hours are the busiest for wardrobe, where employees pick up their uniforms. There's everything from maintenance, foods, hotel, rides, games, merchandise.
We are jammed in here quite tightly. This year we fit around 4,500 kids, and each one has two sets that they take with them, and an extra one we keep here to exchange when they come for their laundry exchange. At the far window, the kids are exchanging their dirty uniforms for clean ones. We exchange one set of uniforms each day, and they just give us dirty ones. We go right away and get them clean ones of the same size and the same item that they brought in.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
In front of me here is the Raptor, and we put the Raptor in 1994. That gave us a record year here at Cedar Point, but this is just one of what we consider to be five world-class coasters that we have here in the park.
Swiss company of Bolliger & Mabillard made this back in 1995. It's one of the first inverted coasters that they built that you actually sit in a seat, your feet are dangling down the track above your head. So it's a very intense ride that's maintained its popularity over all these years.
It's not, you know, the tallest, but it is still best simply because it's fun. There's no other way to describe it.
As you go through, it's a very smooth ride. It's just a very interesting layout, very intense ride.
For the answers to any questions about the park, call the experts.
Cedar Point Information, this is Betty. How may I help you? Part of my job is to answer the telephone, answer all the questions about the park, the surrounding areas. We do all the labeling for the coupon books that are sent out, and most of the mailings come through this office. We do that in between answering phones. All right, we're open every day up through September the 4th, which is Labor Day. They want to know about height requirements for the rides, prices of the tickets, hotel reservations, which we transfer back to the reservation number. This is our Bible, and it tells everything. Anything you want to know about attendance, admission, height requirements, events listings, music showcase festival, physics day, Coaster Mania that's in June. It's just a wealth of information.
But there are even a few calls that leave the staff stumped.
They want to know if they can air condition the park.
Well, some people have called and asked, what's the name of your park?
And one time they asked me if the lake was still here.
If it does rain hard or there's lightning, most of the roller coasters go down. The rides that are undercover continue. Once it stopped raining, they dry off the roller coasters and put them back in operation as soon as possible. My kids say, there's nothing I do better than talk. So this was the job for me.
By noon, guests have worked up a hearty appetite. Cedar Point has an on-site picnic area. Guests can cook their own meals or bring them in and leave them at the picnic tables while they conquer the rides. But how does the world's largest amusement park feed a public hungry for your typical park foods?
Two cheeseburgers, three fries, a chocolate egg mod.
Cedar Point is unique in food services from the standpoint that we have everything from homemade French fries to gourmet meals. We have quick service restaurants, buffet restaurants, specialty carts. We have over 100 locations throughout the park that offer different forms of food service to our guests. Most challenging part is really consistency, and that's our main goal. We want to provide the same experience Monday through Sunday, every day of the week, every week of the month. Quantity-wise, it's astronomical. We serve enough hot dogs to go from here to Cleveland 12 times if they were laid end to end.
In 2000, Cedar Point guests ate more than 190,000 pounds of hamburger patties, 91 miles of hot dogs, 29,000 gallons of ice cream, and 595 tons of French fried potatoes.
One of the things that the people remember, we sort of take it for granted, but are the sights and the smells of Cedar Point. The smell of cotton candy or caramel apples or those honey glazed nuts, those are things that you remember. And it's all part of the atmosphere of Cedar Point.
While rides are the main attraction, Cedar Point also offers a variety of live shows and entertainment.
What we do is we build all the costumes for the live entertainment at Cedar Point. And what we do is start from design and concept to finished product. I'd say on average we're dealing with anywhere from 750 to 2,000 individual costume pieces a season. Everything's made new every year. Everything is individually fitted and made for that specific person. They come in on usually a Sunday or a Monday, have a first fitting, and by Wednesday we have the costumes finished and they're wearing them out on stage.
This is the America cast, all these crazy people that I'm working with. We want to make sure that we don't injure ourselves during the show, because if we do, then we can do our job. But yeah, we make sure that we try to warm up every part of our body, which we use in this show, every single joint. Our vocal cords are basically like the same muscles that we have in our body. They stretch and flex and all that. And we gotta make sure that they are warmed up before we start stretching them to do all the high and the low singing that we do here. In total, we have what, like 8 costume changes? We have like, at the most, what, 15, 20 seconds for some changes. What we do is we run in through one side, we take off the tie, rip off the shirt, put on something else, and run out the other side. Thanks to Velcro, we're able to make those costume changes fairly quickly. It's pretty fast-paced back here. In fact, the real show is back here with what we're doing. No.
When afternoon arrives, it's the perfect time to hit the water at Soak City.
Soak City is the Cedar Point of water parks. We have a wave pool, 2 inner tube rivers, body slides, tube slides, a family raft ride, an Adventure Cove, which is a youth area, and 2 children's areas. When I lifeguard at the wave pool, I'm constantly scanning my water and watching for distressed swimmers, people who are tired. When the waves go on, they get tired and they're more likely to have trouble then. I'm also looking for people who might flip off their tubes and hit their heads on the bottom. I do a double triangle pattern. When I scan, I look out, I look across, I look out again, I look back across, I look down in front of me, look out, look straight across, look down. That's how I scan. I've had 11 total rescues at Soak City this summer.
This is Bubble Swim Up Bar here at Cedar Point, and it's designed for the adults. It allows the adults to get away from the kids and relax a little bit and to have a good time and forget about all their troubles at home. So, cheers!
The Cedar Point Police Department is a very unique situation because we do have an actual police department here. Actually, we're commissioned through the city of Sandusky, which is the jurisdiction that Cedar Point falls into. and that's how we get our authority to make the arrest if we have to make an arrest situation.
The Cedar Point Police Department has a host of tools to help them ensure the safety and security of the guests. All 911 calls from the park's pay phones are routed to this office.
It prints out the location where the call came in at, and as you can see, it has the other police departments in our county. For whatever reason, we can transfer a call to another police department.
Monitoring of the park is provided via remote-controlled video cameras located throughout the park.
We can keep an eye on the entrances, the exits, and just different areas throughout the park. Scans all the way around so we can keep an eye on the toll booths also.
Officers in the field assist with crowd control.
They do visual checks to make sure there's no line jumping. Primarily their responsibility is just to make sure that everyone, you know, is behaving and the lines are flowing smoothly.
Knowing and responding to everything that's happening in the daily operation of every area of the park is what Park Operations does on a second-to-second basis. It functions much like Command Central, directing employees to areas that require immediate attention.
We monitor everything. We want to know what's going on in the park. We know how many cars we park on a given day. We know how many people are in the park. We know what time they've come in. We know what rides they ride. We know if they go to the water park. All this allows us to map our daily activities, so we know what to do. One of the most important things we do is monitor the weather. We're an outdoor venue. Everything we do is weather dependent. If it's cold, we may need to add weight to roller coaster trains in the morning when we get them running. If it's hot, that means our water parks will be busy, so we have to shift staffing to that direction. If there's storms coming, we need to be prepared. We receive, via satellite, constantly updated radar images of the weather patterns that are passing overhead. And I would say we may get a little rain in the next few minutes.
A passing thunderstorm offers the perfect opportunity to blast into the past by visiting the park's on-site museum.
Cedar Point has one of the longest histories of any summer resort in the United States. But Cedar Point started in 1870. It was very small at that time. It was primarily a beer garden and a few bathhouses and so forth. I think it's important to remember that summer resorts from the 1890s until the 1920s predated radio, far predated television, and really represented the very early days of the movie industry. So summer resorts and amusement parks, when they started to develop, were one of the most popular entertainment forms in the United States. I think part of what makes Cedar Point unique is its geography. The fact that it's located on a beautiful peninsula, located in Lake Erie, and with probably one of the best bathing beaches in the world. That, combined with the fact that it has amassed this tremendous collection of roller coasters and rides, has made Cedar Point a very unique operation.
This is the Magnum XL 200. This coaster was the coaster that fired the first shots in the coaster wars. It was built in 1989. It was the first coaster to go over 200 feet and to exceed speeds of 70 miles an hour. It has done everything that we expected it to do and even more.
I first came to Cedar Point in 93, and I was terrified of coasters, and I was forced on the Magnum, and that's when I lost my fear of roller coasters. I come to Cedar Point normally two or three times a week, and so I'm a season pass holder, so I come here a lot. I started keeping count of my Magnum rides in May of 97, and as of today, I'm up to 1,235. I can ride the Magnum till I die. I mean, it's just a great ride, and I haven't gotten bored of it yet, so I'm gonna keep on riding.
Here we go.
Woo-hoo! We're reaching a top speed of 72 miles an hour. We're at the top of the second hill now. 154 feet in the air. Great view of Lake Erie. We're going down the second hill. We're about to enter one of the first three tunnels. Woo! Going over the third hill now. Provides maximum air time. Now, we're going into Magnum. 360-degree turnaround pretzel, designed to be a real fast turnaround. Send you back. Now we're going into the second tunnel. Now we're getting ready for the part that makes Magnum truly the king of all steel roller coasters. It's ending finale of perfectly designed bunny hills. These bunny hills are designed to give maximum air maritime. Now we're into the third and final tunnel. There you have it, ride of the Magnum XL 200, world's greatest steel roller coaster.
While we only market to about a 250-mile radius, the reputations with the roller coasters has gotten all over, and people do come from all over the United States to come to Cedar Point. So to accommodate those people, why we have put a lot of capital dollars into expanding our hotel reservation system in our hotel rooms, where as today, we have over 1,400 rooms to accommodate these requests.
Cedar Point's oldest and most popular hotel is Hotel Breakers. Families and guests return here year after year, and so do the bellhops, who've been a tradition since 1905.
Hi, Mr. Comport.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I have your luggage.
Very good. That was quick.
Right there. Right here. There's a lot of the young college students and younger people that do this job. A lot of them are working for their college degrees and their college money. Well, I'm working for my daughter's college money. This job, it will keep you young, keep you in shape. And I've always told the younger bellhops, I said, now if I can't do the job, I'll quit. If I can't keep up with you, I'll quit. And the first year I came, and I was kind of amazed at the weight that I lost, the number of pounds I lost. I lost 25 pounds in the first summer I was here.
What do I think about Hank? Well, he keeps up just fine. You can't tell that he's however old he is. No, I'm just kidding. But I don't know, Hank is real honest. He's real reliable. I'll definitely give him credit for that.
Thank you. 33-24, gotcha.
Hotel Breakers is a nationally registered historic hotel. Because there are no elevators in the original part of the building, the bellmen have become extremely important to guest services. Hotels filled to capacity keep linen services busy every hour of the day.
That is a bell going off. The washer is just about done. You'll be seeing towels come out. Zach, you want to take the towels off for me, please? This is a four-bank washer, 125 pounds of towels in each bank. There are two banks on top, two banks below. They're going down to the dryers, loading, and we're going to reload for the next one. 125 pounds of bank, everything is pre-weighed. Not more than probably about 3 or 4 hours ago, these towels were in the rooms, and the guests were using them. And in about 2 hours, they'll be back in the rooms again. Claire? Chemicals added, and he's starting it up. It's an ongoing process all night long. Challenging part is staying on time, making sure everything's flowing the way it's supposed to. If we don't keep this going, we're in a world of hurt, because the dirty linen comes down continuously, day in, day out, after every hour, does not stop. If we fall behind or have a breakdown, it does not matter. The dirty linen still comes. Our guests really never know that we exist here, but I guess that's the way it should be. They don't know about us, but if they had dirty sheets, dirty napkins, dirty blankets, they would certainly know that. As long as we do our job, they have clean linen, and they never know about us, and that's all right.
Planning and design handles the creative aspects of the rides and attractions, including 3D sculpting and restoration. They also design and print the park's brochures and flyers. What most people don't realize is how the department decides which new rides will go into the park, the theming and colors of the attractions, and strategizes their location.
If you're designing a new park, what you tend to do is you put
big attractions opposite one another in the park itself. So you can promote circulation. And on one end of the park might be a major ride, and on the opposite end maybe another. And that way you won't crowd everyone into one corner in the park. But at Cedar Point, we have so much product, and you'll find areas in this park where there's a roller coaster on top of a roller coaster, on top of another ride. And the energy level in the park on a Saturday in August is just tremendous. And I think getting the rides in the right position has a lot to do with that.
Rob's department also oversees the creation and development of future rides and attractions. They're included in the top secret 3 to 5 year master plan.
Have this. Get this back! Don't show anyone.
In the same building, John Taylor manages the props that fill the park, including these cemetery decorations for Cedar Point's Halloween weekend event, and all the park's signage.
What we're doing more around the shop is we're using computers. So this was actually cut out of high density foam with a computer. It was all routed, and then we hand paint the details on it. The computer is cutting the vinyl letters that will be applied on the signs.
Graphic Services makes 7,000 signs each year. To keep the world's largest park clean, 2,000 trash cans are scattered throughout Cedar Point. But sometimes the job requires a human touch, the Cedar Point sweepers, who are highly visible throughout the park.
Each person is in a section for 15 minutes, and each zone is divided into 4 sections. So everyone is in a different zone at every time. Sometimes we bump into each other, but not very often. I like moving around a lot more, because in rides you're in one place all day and it gets boring. Here I'm always walking around, there's always something different to look at. There's always a lot of cigarette butts. That's the main thing we pick up all day.
Each sweeper collects more than 8,000 unsightly cigarette butts each day.
I think most people appreciate my job. A lot of people tell us we're doing a good job and the park looks really clean. But I don't think some people realize how hard we work to keep the park clean.
Cedar Point is known as one of the cleanest parks in the country.
Keeping the park clean is a big deal. We got people all day, all night cleaning the park, bringing the trash to these central locations, which I get started in the morning dumping the boxes.
5 night sweeping crews work from midnight until 7 a.m. cleaning the park. They're part of a 700-member workforce that collects more than 500 tons of trash each week at the park.
Right now, we're pulling on the scale. They're going to weigh us. You pay by the weight. It's so much a ton. I think it's $34 a ton. It weighs us full, and then we got to weigh again when we get empty.
I'm a member of the American Coach Enthusiasts. I've been a member since 1979, and I have been coming to Cedar Point every year of my life. Every year, things change, but there's always a familiarity about coming to Cedar Point, walking down the midway, smelling the French fries, looking at the roller coasters. It's all part of the Cedar Point experience. I think Cedar Point rates so well because it's constantly adding new things, and it's constantly upgrading. It's pushing the envelope. It's doing new things like Millennium Force. Millennium Force is the first 300-foot roller coaster in the world. It opened the year 2000, and it is an incredible ride. It has the very first elevator cable lift system, which allows the coaster train to be pulled up at an extremely steep angle really fast. And it's very quiet. It doesn't have that clickety-clack that the older wooden coasters and even some of the modern steel coasters have. The first time I rode it, it was just eerily silent going up there. First drop on Millennium Force is, without a doubt, the most intense drop of any coaster I've ever been on. And if you sit in the back seat, you really feel like you're going to be pitched into Sandusky Bay. Never loses its speed, even till the end. It is a constant, all-out adrenaline rush.
It's going 65 miles an hour, and that's at the end of the ride.
It's incredible. I don't know any other way to describe it.
We're going up 310 feet. We're gonna drop 300 feet at an 80 degree angle. We're gonna be going over 94 miles an hour. Adrenaline, if you're an adrenaline junkie, you're gonna love Millennium Force. Gotta get to Cedar Point and ride it.
Nothing like it.
Great.
Are you all right?
Scary, but it was fun. It was great. Now that I can breathe.
And 11 years ago, when we put in the Magnum XL 200, I really wondered if that could ever be topped, but this ride has truly done that.
Welcome back, Yellow Train Riders. How was your ride?
While the most popular coaster is Millennium Force, the most popular seasonal job at Cedar Point is ride operation.
Enjoy the rest of your day at Cedar Point, America's roller coaster.
Ride supervisors assign the operators a series of duties to ensure guest safety.
For your safety, please keep your hands down inside the train at all times. Enjoy your ride on the fort. Shoulder and chest speaking.
The thumb means that all the employees are clear from the train. It also, the person that controls dispatches the train, but all the thumbs from everybody else means they're clear from the train.
Ride operators rotate positions in the station. They're trained to know how to dispatch and operate the ride controls.
Here is the main menu. And here is the automatic menu, which explains the seconds from the top of the lift to the brake. It's usually around 60 seconds for the train to run from the top of the lift to the brake.
Head sound times.
I got you.
Put your hat down your shirt, please.
No, my shirt.
Yep.
Ride operators check seat belts, lap bars, and handle the loading of the trains.
Two back here.
They rotate positions every 30 minutes to 2 hours to stay alert and become knowledgeable about all aspects of the ride.
Up, need to leave your camera in and your fanny pack.
Absolutely.
Thank you. The ride travels 92 miles an hour, and if any articles fly off, they may hurt someone. So for the safety of the ride, we are asked to make sure that all the guests put their backpacks, purses, cell phones, beepers, walkie-talkies, stuffed animals inside of a locker. Water bottle, you're gonna need to leave your water bottle in a locker. You cannot bring that through the line. Okay. You show a locker key, you can rejoin your group.
Alright.
You need to leave your beeper in a locker to your left. Or non-rider. There you go. I am looking for children, make sure they're above 54 inches. No, I can't accept them. Yep, you're okay. You're alright. Yep, he's alright. Right now, for these people walking in, it's about an hour away.
At 4 p.m., light show engineers load the pyrotechnical effects that will be used later tonight during the park's laser show.
The most rewarding part of the job for me is right here today. Being in the park when it's full of people, seeing happy faces, families together. You work all week to come into the park on Saturdays and see a full park with happy people enjoying themselves. This is what working in an amusement park is all about.
As the sun sets over Sandusky Bay, park guests continue to seek out more thrills and continue their quest into the evening. At 9 p.m., the laser show staff begins preparing for the nightly laser control show, which is offered free to all the guests.
This is our main control systems down here in this room. What we have over here is our audio decks, amplifiers, mixing board, lighting, pyro control system, which shoots our fireworks, and then our effects lasers, foggers, and the video control system here. Everything is synchronized on our audio tapes, which is synchronized with the video. Everything is pretty much computerized controlled, push start, and away it goes.
During the height of summer, 11 p.m. signals closing time. Guests still standing in a ride line, however, will be cycled through, so they will have one last chance to enjoy their adrenaline rush before heading home.
So that was the last ride of the night.
Couldn't think of a better way to end the day. It's perfect. Nothing like flying without seeing anything. Fantastic.
Guests slowly file out of the park and purchase keepsakes of their memorable time.
This was a fun day at Cedar Point.
Then the evening cleanup begins. It may look like lights out at Cedar Point, but the cleaning and maintenance crews have already started their early morning shifts. And then, in a few hours, it will start all over again. The clock never stops here, ticking 24 hours a day, 6 months of the year. It's what makes the public pursuit of fun and fear possible at the world's largest amusement park.